But how long does not seem to be hide very largely to follow him? It seems to be rather difficult. If we look at the gospel today, we got to get the impression, Jesus tells us, be careful, it's not so easy. So sometimes I ask myself, oh Lord, did you really want that we follow you? Why you make it so difficult? Is it not too difficult what you ask us? Well, let us look. What is what Jesus asked us to do when we follow him? In the Gospel of today, it is the beginning of his journey to Jerusalem. He is walking from Galilee to Jerusalem, and we know what is happening there, what will happen to him in Jerusalem, how they will treat him there. And so we understand that his disciples are rather afraid. Why do you go to Jerusalem? It's so dangerous. They will kill you. Why do you go there? But Jesus sends his disciples ahead of him to all the villages where he wants to come. And you have heard there's a special message. In the translation we have, it's not very clear, but in the original text it is said, he sent them two and two. Never he sent them alone. One Christian is no Christian. We cannot live without community. We cannot live our Christian life alone. And the church fathers ask, why did Jesus send the apostles two and two? And the answer is very simple. You cannot practice charity alone. If you have a neighbor, if you have a wife or husband, if you have colleagues, then you have to practice charity. If you are alone, it's easy. Therefore, Jesus always sends us together, never alone. And that's the first advice I would ask you to keep in mind. Keep together, stay together. You are here in a foreign country, most of you. You are here trying to settle down. Some of you have settled. Others are looking for work, looking for permit to stay. All that is not easy. But stay together. And therefore, I am so grateful to your priests who keep together the community. A sheep that goes away from the herd, how do you say? The flock. That separates from the flock is in great danger. There are wolves around. A Christian that separates from the community is in danger. So, my first request, stay together, pray together, worship together, then you are not in danger to get lost in the big city of Vienna. The second point is, these disciples of Jesus were not always received with great hospitality. In the village where they wanted to pass the night, they were not received because they were Jews. And the Samaritans did not like the Jews. It is a very familiar situation today. You came into a city where not everybody is happy to receive you. You all have probably experienced that you are not welcome. Of course, you are welcome in the Christian community. But are you always welcome in the city of Vienna, among the people here? So, what was the reaction of the apostles, John and James? The thunder sons, as Jesus called them. These unholy apostles ask that God may throw down fire on this city. Sometimes you may have similar thoughts in your heart when you are not well received in this city. Well, the apostles had no possibility to throw down fire. It was only God's power that could have done it. And God said, the Lord said, no, you don't know what you ask. He has not come to spread the good news with fire and sword. Christian faith has not to be spread, to be announced with violence and bombs and terror. That is not the Christian way. And therefore, I ask you that this is my second request. If you are sometimes unfriendly, if you meet unfriendly faces, if you meet unfriendly people, give them the Christian witness. We need the Christian witness. And it is astonishing how much you can change the hearts if instead of having a grim and angry face, you smile, you tend a hand. It's hard, but it's very rewarding. It's what makes us true followers of Jesus. So allow me to say what I expect from your community in this city of Vienna. You can contribute, change the hearts by your attitude. Being in a difficult situation, being sometimes humiliated, fighting for daily life, for survival in the struggle of daily life, keeping Jesus' love in your heart.